The Premier has added her voice to a chorus of Western Sydney mayors outraged over Victoria's decision to ban 10 areas or around a million people from entering their state. That's despite another day of zero cases here in New South Wales, as some families opened up about the emotional suffering caused by the border blockade.
When you haven't seen your parents in over a year, there's only one thing to do.
Hug mum, yeah. Well, I'm going to get swabbed first and then I'm going to hug mum after I'm isolated.
But for some Sydneysiders touching down in Melbourne this morning, it was too late. Jacinda Poole's mum died on Sunday without her daughter and granddaughter, excluded because they live in southwest Sydney.
This is my mum I'm talking about. Everybody loves and care for their mum. This is not right what they was doing to us.
It was hard to get an exemption because they asked me I need to prove that why we're coming to Melbourne. So I had to contact Monash Hospital. Monash Hospital wanted to prove that she's my grandmother. I'm like, how do you expect me to prove something like that?
Today, a second mayor from the exclusion zones hit out.
To Dan Andrews, I call on you, stop being a self-important little bedwetter and do what's right. Now, the rules are being made up as he goes along. They're not consistent.
His second barb, at least, is backed by our Premier.
First of all, I don't really understand the traffic light system. I just want to make that clear.
While most of the banned local government areas, including Fairfield and Cumberland, have had cases in the past 2 weeks, there's one glaring inconsistency. The Northern Beaches has also recorded cases in the past 14 days, but locals from there are still allowed to travel to Victoria.
As soon as we can release any of those local government areas, and that is to move them from red to orange, that's exactly what we will do.
But he's warning a green status for Sydney is still some weeks away.
It's not a reflection on their community, it's not a reflection on them. It's a reflection on the fact that this is a wildly infectious virus.
But the nation is once again divided.
By any way of looking at hotspots, there just aren't any.
There is currently no part of Australia that is a hotspot. Therefore, there should be no border which is closed to Australian citizens.
I just urge the New South Wales Liberal government to stop. Their constant criticism and carping is getting tiresome. They need to just leave it alone.
Health authorities are still working to find the source of 9 previous mystery cases in New South Wales, and time is running out, with Queensland set to make its decision on the border on January 28th. In Western Sydney today, their patience was running out.
Absolutely disappointed because most of people, for example me, I've got business all around Australia, and I cannot go.
As the state recorded its second day of zero community cases, the calls for consistency will only get louder. Ursula Hager for 10 News First.